What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about how to create complex geometry in Revit, and we're actually going to be exploring how to create these cool kind of curved walls inside of Revit. Now if you want to learn more about complex forms and complex shapes inside of Revit, I have an entire course where I cover pretty much the whole approach to creating this complex geometry inside of Revit, and then also going from that complex geometry into actual kind of building elements, turning it into walls, floors, windows, curtain walls, and so on. So if you're interested, it's available on my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There, apart from this course, you can find some of my other courses. I have over 130 hours of content, and I'm even adding more each month. And then also you can find there some other things like some ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, and also there is a plugin that might interest you too. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am at the home screen in Revit. So I'm just going to go here to models and then go to new. As for the template file, as I said, I have my own custom templates. So in this case, I'm just going to be using my architecture design template. As I said, it's available on my website, and I'm going to be leaving a link to this template in the cards above. Now let's just click OK and let's let Revit start right up. So as soon as Revit starts up, I'm going to go to the 3D view, and let's get rid of this starting view. And now let's move our level 2 from 360 centimeters all the way up to 1000 centimeters, or 10 meters, because I need this for my walls. Okay, so once I have this in place, let's now start with the first shape. So here I have an image. This is just that image that they've shown you in the beginning, or the project that they've shown you in the beginning. And here you can see we have this small wall segment. It's a short wall segment that's curved. It looks really good. So let's explore the first approach now with this smaller wall, and then I'm going to be showing you a more complicated approach for more complicated geometry. So what I'm going to do now is go here to Massing and Site, go to Show Mass, turn on Show Mass, and then let's go to In Place Mass. You can name it if you want. I'm just going to leave the name as Mass 1. And now let's start. So what you want to do first is just go here to the Draw panel, go to the Spline tool, and now you have two spline tools. You have Spline and Spline Through Points. Now Spline Through Points is going to work a lot better in this case, and in most cases, kind of when it comes to this complex geometry, just because it has, I guess, just better properties for carrying out these complex shapes and forms. So let's just click on that. Then we want to set the work plane. Now you can set it here because we already have it. So I'm just going to leave it at placement plane level 1. And then also I like to make sure that here it says drawn work plane. So not here, but here. Okay, so now we can get started. So as this is a simple wall, I'm just going to make a few clicks, kind of like that. Okay, and then go to modify to stop that. Okay, so this is kind of what we have on the bottom. Now we can go here to the view cube and kind of look at it top down, and then let's go again to the spline tool, and let's change this from level 1 to level 2, and now let's do the second one. So I'm just going to do 4 points again, and then I'm just going to make it kind of like that. Okay. Now you can actually modify this even further, so it doesn't have to be flat on top and bottom, but for now let's just leave it as is and let's complete the form. So I'm just going to select the top one and the bottom one. So you hold the control key to add to selection, and then you can select multiple ones, so like this, and then you just go to create form. So it's going to create a form like this. Now, as I said, you can edit this. You hover over it, hit the tab key until it highlights the entire shape or entire form, and then you go here to the X-ray function. So it's just going to break it down to all of the elements. And here, this is kind of where the position of this is on top. Usually, I don't like to mess around with this. And then what you want to do here, just to get here, if I just bring this image up again, see how the top isn't flat? It actually follows kind of like a curve. Well, we can actually do that here by moving this point up, just like that. See? Then I can move this point a little bit down if I want, and then I can move this one even further down if I want. So now, as you can see on the top, we're getting that curved shape, exactly what we were looking for. Now you might think, okay, that's all nice and well, and it looks exactly how we want it to look, but why is it still weird like this? Well, we can come again and go to hit the tab key, select the thing, and then just uncheck the x-ray function, and now it's back to normal, like this. Okay, so that's the first approach, and I would call it like the simpler approach. Now let's move over to the more complicated approach. So for this, you again want to start with a spline. So we're always working with splines when we're creating curves, because they're, well, the best for that. I'm going to switch this back to level 1. Again, make sure that the drawn work plane is selected, and let's get started. So I'm just going to create like something like that. So what you want to think about this is basically the path of our wall, so kind of the bottom of the wall. Okay, then you want to go to the point element tool, or sorry, just the point element. It's the draw tool. And then you want to make sure that here it's set to draw on face. So it's going to figure out which face you're on. See, if I'm here, it's going to figure out that I'm on this face. If I'm here, it's going to figure out that I'm on this work plane. And then if I highlight the line, it's going to place it on a line. So I can just place it like this on this spline. So this point is now hosted on that spline. Okay, so this point has its own reference planes. So what I can do is I can go here to set reference plane, hover over this thing, and then it's just going to select that reference plane. Now you can even select it, and I think we can have the reference planes show. Is this here? Apply, nope. So we should have a function where, okay, yeah, sorry, here, always. There we go. So it's now always going to show that reference plane. So anyways, once we, and let's get rid of this visible because I don't know what that is. Okay, so once we have this in place, now I can go to a spline. I can go to set work plane and then select the reference plane. And then, as you can see, now we can draw on that point or the reference plane of that point. Now you have to go back here to draw on work plane because we just want to stick to this work plane. And then I can create a creative spline that goes, I don't know, like this. There we go. So I can have an interesting spline like so. Okay, so once I have this in place, what you want to do next is select both the point and the spline, and then you just want to copy it. And you just want to copy it off to the side, and you want to copy it multiple times. So make sure that multiple is selected here. Okay, so once you have done this, it's going to look a little bit weird, and that's okay. So what you want to do next is just select the points. So you select one of these points, you go to pick new host, and then you can come here on this reference plane, and then you can pick it. So it's just going to host it back to that reference plane, to the other position on the reference plane, like so. Then let's do that for this one, pick new host, and then this one as well, pick new host, place it there, perfect. And then this one, if we don't want it, we can just get rid of it by deleting it. And then we can select this point and we can even slide it towards the front of this spline. Okay, so now once we have all of this in place, and now we can modify all of these individual splines that are hosted on the points in order to make kind of a variety on this wall that we're creating. So for example, for this beginning one, I'm just going to shorten it a little bit, so make it smaller. Now I explore in the course how to play around with these gizmos, which is this thing that has all of the arrows. So I'm not going to go too much into that here, but anyways, let's just start with something like this. Then for this point, let's just move it like that. And this point here. So you just modify these points a little bit, then this one is fine, let's say, and then this one I want it to be super tall. I don't know, like that. Okay, and then finally for this one, we can make it, yeah, we can just leave it as is. So anyways, now you select the path, you hold the control key, you select all of the splines that are along the way. hold the control key, select all of those, and now you go to create form, and it's just going to connect all of those in a cool form. Now, again, you can edit this. You can just select the thing. You can go to X-ray, and now you can make modifications to that form. You might be thinking, well, we can do this the same exact thing as we did here, which is true. But here you just have a little bit more versatility because you can now play around with this, the height of this thing, and then you can really go crazy with it. Now, of course, don't go too crazy because sometimes it will break kind of the shape, but you do have the ability to do whatever you want. So you can kind of move these things around a lot, and as you can see, the whole thing will change, and then I can select this point here if I can, and then I can move that. So you can make some really drastic changes here to that shape, and it's just going to adapt to that. So anyways, here we have kind of the completed shape. Now obviously this is just now kind of see-through geometry, and now you want to turn this into actual walls. So you do that by going here to finish mask. Once you're done with that, then you go to architecture, or sorry, you go to masking and site, you go to wall, and then you simply pick out a wall. Let's go exterior wall. You select this, and it's going to turn that into an actual wall. So yeah, it's a wall. Let's turn this into shaded. There we go. So now this has been turned into an actual kind of actual Revit models, so actual wall and building elements. Now you can take this workflow even further, and you can create things that look like this. So here I have used, basically it's a kind of a louver system that follows kind of a curved geometry of a wall. So basically, if you want to learn this, I'm going to be creating an extra video for this that I'm going to be posting on my Patreon page. So if you don't know, I have a Patreon page. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit project files, like this project file here, and then also I'm just going to be including this video on how to create this type of a wall over there on that Patreon page, so make sure to check it out. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.